When you think of double Ds, you only think of one thing. That's right, the 64DD, or the 64 disk drive, get your mind out the gutter. The 64DD was a magnetic floppy disk drive that was developed for the N64. It was first announced in 95, but wouldn't be released until 1999. The disks themselves would be 64 megabytes in space, and the device itself would fit in the extension port underneath the N64. The 64DD would then go on to be discontinued in late 2000, prior to the GameCube's launch in 2001. Now, there's some things that I just know I'm never going to own. So in this video, I'm going to show you how I emulated the 64DD on the PC. Before we get stuck in, please like, subscribe, comment, all that fun stuff. Let's get stuck in. So I'll throw a link for this guide down below, but what you're going to have to do is download the Project 64 emulator for the PC. Once you've got the latest build, you need to go back to the guide and download the IPL files. Now, these seem to be like the ROM files for the actual device itself to make it work. So once you've done that, you need to go into your configuration, load them up, and once you've done that, save it, and you're good to go. Once that's done, you'll need to configure all your graphics plugins, as well as your input for your controller. Now, I've had to kind of chop back and forward here a wee bit. When it came to the N64 mouse, for whatever reason, I just couldn't get it to work, so there's probably something I've done wrong, but I am going to keep looking into it. Now, once you've got the graphics, the input, and the audio and everything set up, you can now boot a game. So, for me here, I'm playing the F0X expansion kit. For that, we needed the Japanese ROM. So, once you've downloaded that, you right-click on it, it'll ask you if you want to play game or play game with disc. Click on that, it'll ask you to load the disk image, then once you've selected that, it'll boot everything up just like a normal emulated game would. The F0X expansion kit is one thing I really wanted to try. Now, F0X is one of my favourite racing games of all time, but in this it gave you the ability to basically make your own vehicles, which was cool. Now, it is kind of limited, there's not any great detail, but it's still cool. And also, there's the track header, which is what I wanted to really have a go at. Basic one here, because I didn't speak Japanese, shock horror. I know I barely speak English, but that was one of the big things for me. Now, in its short life cycle, it did only release 10 discs in total. There's Mario Artist Paint Studio, Talent Studio, Communication Kit, and Polygon Studio. There's also Doshin the Giant, Tinkling Toddler, and just Doshin the Giant. There was the RadNet disc, which was going to give you the ability to play online. There was SimCity 64, and there was the F0X expansion kit. Oh, there's also Japan Pro Golf Tour. There was 60 games announced at the time, notably Diablo was meant to come out, Fire Emblem, Pokemon RPG, Mother 3, and Resident Evil 0, which would later come out on the GameCube. So there are a couple of games in particular that I really wanted to try when loading up the 64DD, and these were games that I've heard about in the past but never got the chance to play until now. One of the big ones is Doshin the Giant. Now, I remember seeing this in a magazine way back when the 64DD was first announced, and I was like, ah, oh, this game looks amazing. I love the look of the protagonist, and just look, it looked awesome. It was mysterious. I wasn't sure at the time what it was all about, and I thought, you know what, this sounds awesome. And playing it now, it's just a cutesy wee game. I'm not going to go into any massive review about it, but I thoroughly enjoyed it here before I decided to go homicidal and kill everybody, just because I was getting on and just getting a bit on in time with the recording and footage. So I was like, ah, just go kill everything. Also, SimCity 64. Now, I'm not the biggest SimCity fan, but I love these kind of theme park, build your city, you know, type games, and I really wanted to try this just to kind of see how it played on the 64, and I love it. Now, again, this is all emulated, so I don't know how it ran on the actual system itself, but this all seemed smooth, it looked nice, and I did enjoy it. Again, no reading Japanese, I was just kind of clicking and hoping for the best to see what would happen, figure it out as I went. But again, thoroughly enjoyed it. So I am happy in total that I got this emulator set up. When kind of getting some of the games up and running, there was issues with the graphics plugins. So if you do come across that issue, just kind of chop and change between the plugins that you have, and it should eventually boot. That's how it worked for me. Anyway, I know each game, not one plugin worked for every game, if you know what I mean. So there we go. That's the 64DD emulated on the PC. Now, realistically, like I said at the start of the video, this is probably the only chance I'll ever have to actually play the 64DD, which is fine. I didn't mind. It'd be cool to have it physically, but again, you're talking about hundreds, if not thousands, for the unit itself, and then there's all the discs and everything like that. It's cool, but I know it's kind of out there for me. But please, let me know down below what you think. Have you played the 64DD, or do you even own it? Is it worth owning physically? Is it worth actually having it in your collection? Please let me know down below. And like I said at the start of the video, if you find this kind of thing useful or helpful or good or enjoyable, please like, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.